Pharmaceutical companies Pfizer and BioNTech, as well as biotech company Moderna, have announced that they completed clinical trials of COVID-19 vaccines. Pfizer submitted its vaccine for emergency approval from the FDA on November 20th, while Moderna submitted its vaccine on November 30th.
The FDA review process will take around 3 weeks, according to the New York Times, which means the vaccine should be approved in early or mid-December.
Data showed both vaccines were about 95% effective at protecting against the virus. In early analyses released recently, the companies had also said that the vaccines appeared over 90% effective. The companies are the first to complete phase 3 clinical testing for a COVID-19 vaccine, which is the final stage before a drug can be approved in the US.
That all sounds great, but what exactly happens now?
Even with the vaccines submitted for emergency approval, answers to these questions will determine not only if these vaccines are approved, but what to expect once a COVID-19 vaccine is available. For starters, both results were published in press releases, not journals reviewed by other scientists.
That's important because until results are published in scientific journals, the most detailed data will be unavailable. It's also unclear if these vaccines prevent only the symptoms of COVID-19 or the infection itself, and if the infection can still be transmitted once the vaccine has been given. There are other hurdles too. The approval process for any drug has a strict set of steps, and COVID-19 vaccines are no exception, even if the process has been sped up.
Moderna and Pfizer both released interim analyses. An interim analysis is a typical part of the clinical trial process in which a group separate from the drug's developers provide an unbiased look at whether the drug seems to be working, is unsafe, or is extremely ineffective.
This is an interim analysis of the effectiveness of the vaccine, or more technically, the efficacy of the vaccine. And so, put differently, in more lay terms, these are preliminary findings about how well the vaccine works. It's not the end of the story for the vaccine, though.
Of the side effects rated most severe, fatigue was the most common in both trials. Pfizer reported that the only other serious side effect was headache. Moderna also listed joint pain, muscle pain, and redness at the injection site. Officials in charge of Pfizer's vaccine development have pointed out that its vaccine's side effects are on par with other adult vaccinations. Another potential downside is that a vaccine will continue to work, but it will only prevent COVID-19 symptoms, not the actual infection.
It is certainly possible and maybe even plausible that many of those cases that got the vaccine were infected and might have even been able to still transmit the virus to other people, but they just did not have serious diseases as a consequence of having been vaccinated.
What we don't know is how well it protects from transmitting the virus. In other words, does it protect people not only from getting sick, but from being contagious to others?
If that's the case for the COVID-19 vaccine, things like social distancing and wearing masks will likely be necessary for much longer.
Although the vaccines have been submitted to the FDA, it will likely take weeks to get emergency approval.
The FDA will then evaluate if the vaccine's benefits outweigh its risks. The process of approving something for emergency use authorization is less extensive than regular FDA approval, but the timeline still varies. The FDA has said that in an emergency, an approval will be acted on within hours or days. The developers are also planning to manufacture their vaccines globally.
Even after a vaccine is approved and available, it remains to be seen who can actually receive one, and when they can do so. Pfizer has plans to make its first doses available to healthcare workers, for instance. Dr. Anthony Fauci has said most people in the U.S. may be able to get a vaccine in April, May, or June of 2021.
It's important that the vaccine isn't the only solution. It's going to have to be paired up with continued prevention, like distancing, staying at home if you're sick, wearing a mask, antibody therapeutics, and how we treat people. All of that comes together in reducing the impact of COVID-19.
Of course, Moderna and Pfizer aren't the only companies developing a COVID-19 vaccine.
Some trials outside the U.S. are promising. For instance, a large British trial by AstraZeneca and Oxford University has also released early data showing that their vaccine could be up to 90% effective against the virus. Although some have raised concerns about AstraZeneca's testing process and interim analysis, if proven effective, their vaccine could prove especially important globally. It costs less than both Pfizer's and Moderna's and can be stored in a normal refrigerator, while the other two need to be kept in ultra-cold freezers.
There are at least 65 vaccines being tested against COVID-19 in phase 3 development alone, and almost 300 in total.
A doctor I spoke to called the vaccine effort mind-blowingly unprecedented. And in this case, unprecedented in a good way.